And it is about equations containing decimals. So say we have an equation that contains a decimal, something like z plus 0.9 equals 1.3. We're going to learn of a couple of ways to do this. So the first method is we're going to work with it just like if it were any other problem, using the addition and multiplication properties of equality. So if I want to isolate z, what do I do here? Subtract 0.9 from both sides, right? If I do that, what ends up happening is I get z, the 0.9 and the negative 0.9 cancel out. So I'm left with z equals 1.3 minus 0.9. What's that?
0.4.
Okay. I can check that the same way that I would check any other problem. Just plug the 0.4 back into z. 0.4. Plus 0.9 should give me, I don't know, but it should give me 1.3. Okay, if I'm lining up my decimals, 4 plus 9 is 13, carry the 1, bring down the decimal point, 0 plus 0 is 0, and 1 is 3. So the two sides equal, which means that my answer is correct. That was using method 1. Method 2 says, let's use what we know about decimals to make our life easier. In some cases it'll be easier, in some cases it won't. So let's say we have the same problem, z plus 0.9 equals 1.3. Remember when we were working with fractions, we multiply everything by the lowest, by the denominator, to get rid of the denominators? Okay, we're going to do something similar here. I want to get rid of my decimals. How can I get rid of my decimals? What can I multiply each one of these numbers by so my decimals go away?
10.
Because what I know about powers of 10 is that if I multiply something by a power of 10, it's going to move my decimal point to the right one place. And that's exactly what I want. If this decimal point moves to the right, and this decimal point moves to the right, I am finished with decimals. So let's do that. So 10 times z is going to give me 10z. 10 times 0.9 is going to give me 9. And 10 times 1.3 is going to give me 13. Okay, once I'm here, I'm just going to solve the equation as usual. So subtract 9 from both sides, and I get 10z equals 13 minus 9, which is 4, and then divide both sides by 10. And here I have division by 10, so any number divided by 10 is just, I'm just going to move the decimal to the left one, so that's going to give me 0.4. This problem it is, and the next problem you'll see it makes it simpler. But yeah, it is a little more work in this one. Perhaps a bad example to start off with. But you guys get the concept. The fact that we multiply by 10 makes our decimals go away. So let's try another one. Let's say we have 0.17x equals negative 0.34. Let's do it both ways. Let's start with method 1. So with method 1, how do I isolate x here?
Divide both sides
by 1700s. Okay? 1700s divided by itself is just 1, so I'm left with x equals, how do I divide those two numbers? Long way, right? I can't divide them as they are, I need to move the decimal points. So that's what I did over here. So I got 17 divided by 34, which is going to be 2. And it's negative because it's a negative divided by a positive. Questions about how I did this, the regular way, method 1? Let's talk about method 2 using the same problem. So method 2 says I want to use what I know about decimals to get rid of the decimals. So if I multiply all of this by some power of 10, my decimals are going to go away. What's the power of 10 I want to multiply by here? 100. So let's see what happens when I do that. When I multiply 17 times 100, it's going to move my decimal twice to the right. So I get 17x. When I multiply 0.34 by 100, it's going to move my decimal point to the right, and I'm going to get negative 34. And if I divide by 17, I get x equals negative 2. Same answer, different way of getting there. Yeah?
If you have x attached to that first number, what makes it so that x gets the times whatever it's behind it?
What we have is 100 times 0.17x. What are you asking?
Well, the x would mean a different multiplication. So what gives that the multiplication of 100? Because right now it pretty much looks like you're doing 17x, which, what's the, where does the x...
Where does the x get multiplied?
Yeah.
Okay, this is the same thing as 100 times 0.17 times x, right?
Exactly.
Which is the same thing as x times 100. I can write it in any order I want. It's still the same thing. Okay. I am going to multiply two of those numbers. So I can multiply these two and then leave the x. Or I can multiply the x times 100 and then leave the 0.17. I'm not going to multiply the 100 times every number. Because it's not a distributive property thing. It's just multiplication of three numbers. So for example, think about multiplying 2 times 3 times 4. I'm not going to multiply 2 times 3 and then 2 times 4. I'm just going to multiply 2 times 3. That's going to give me 6, and then multiply that times 4. So the idea is you only multiply the 0.17 times 100. The x you don't need to multiply by 100. We're not distributing 100. Okay. Good question. Okay. Let's try another one. So let's say we have 6 3/10 - 5x = 3 × x + 2 9/10. So again, we could do method 1 or method 2. Why don't you go ahead and use whatever method you want, and I'll try method 2 when I do it myself.